So our video for today will be about the 1981 Mr. Olympia, which has been widely considered as one of the darkest events in bodybuilding's history. The year before, Arnold Schwarzenegger won the 1980 Mr. Olympia in a controversial manner. First, he was not going to compete, and then all of a sudden he is on stage going up against the best bodybuilders in the world at that time. If he should have won or not is still discussed today. But saying this, Arnold had a decent physique to go up against the best. After the 1980 Mr. Olympia, favorites such as Frank Zane, Mike Menzer, and Boyer Coe boycotted the 1981 Mr. Olympia. So the IFBB convinced old-timers such as Ken Waller, Mike Katz, and Ed Corney to take part. One bodybuilder that saw a window of opportunity was Franco Colombo. The 1976 Mr. Olympia winner obviously thought that if his best friend did it in 1980, then he could as well. The problem was that this time around, even though bodybuilders such as Frank Zane and Mike Menzer decided not to compete, bodybuilders Chris Dickerson, Tom Platz, and Danny Padilla were at the top of their game and in the best shape of their lives. Franco was suffering from some heavy gyno, and his legs, arms, and even back were no match compared to Padilla and Platz. Danny Padilla was nicknamed the Giant Killer because of his amazing ability to defeat much taller competitors. He stands 5 feet and 2 inches tall, which is equal to 158 centimeters. I do believe he was better and definitely more aesthetic than Franco was. Just take a look at the front double biceps pose and tell me how Franco managed to win. Danny's physique was flawless. His arms were incredible and his V taper along with his small waist added to his aesthetics. His wheels were huge and separated, and he was also known for hitting the stomach vacuum pose. Any observer, whether an expert or not, would tell you Danny looks more proportional and pleasant to the eye than Franco. His aesthetic lines were second to none, and he definitely should have placed higher than fifth that year. Do you think Franco rightfully won? Let me know what you think in the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe, and many thanks for watching. Have a nice one.